All right, let's talk a little bit about dog harnesses. Dog harnesses are designed to make the dog the most comfortable while pulling. So if you pull on a dog to correct the dog for being reactive, barking, whatever you may be correcting for, even if it's just correcting for pulling on the dog won't do anything because it doesn't hurt the dog. It's designed not to hurt the dog. So I'm going to be demonstrating outside the difference between walking this dog with a long leash on the harness, and then demonstrating how I would normally use the leash on the harness. And then I will demonstrate the head control with the same leash, with the same harness, in a different manner. So three different techniques with the same equipment. So the point I'm trying to demonstrate here is that you could use the same equipment multiple different ways and get multiple different effects. So yeah, enjoy. This is going to be a longer video explaining the styles of leashes and how you could use your different tools to your advantage in different situations. So this is your common rope leash. You have a hook at the end where you usually put it onto a flat collar. I'm trying to demonstrate you could use this for more than one reason. For a training leash, you want to have a slip leash. So you have more control over your dog when it's on a slip leash than when it's on a normal leash. Up! 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 Here. Here. Sit. Sit. By being on a slip leash, he can't pull or else it'll start choking him. So when he stops pulling, it'll start giving some give. If you don't want to use it like this, you could put it through the hoop instead of just using the clip and put the hoop over your dog's head. And it has more give when you let go now. It's more high risk now. Now it has so much give that you can't use this as your primary leash, as if he gets out, obviously that's not good for anyone. So by keeping your dog on a training leash, you could sit, like he's trying to escape the situation. He's getting bored. So by keeping him on a training leash, you could control him better. If you're losing control of your dog, it's up to you to upgrade your tools in your favor. So again, the better way of holding your leash is actually behind you, holding it firmly with your left hand, guiding your dog with your right hand, or you could switch this up, like it does go both ways. And then you could give the commands with your right. If your dog doesn't pull, you could anchor with your body and pull with your right as well. So you're doing minimal amount of effort to keep your dog in control. And the point of doing minimal amount of effort is if you're using a lot of force pulling on that flat collar to try to get your dog to stop, they're going to be hurting their trachea, they're going to be choking themselves out, and they're not going to be learning very effectively. So when something happens quick, it's effective. That's the reason why it works. So this is just using a normal slip lead. I don't like using these as much as I like using a prong collar. And the reason why you want to use a prong collar as opposed to using a slip leash, in my opinion, is it requires less force on your behalf to correct the dog. You can literally correct the dog with one finger as opposed to having to use your full arm. So by having the dog on a prong collar, here, come here. So I slip it under his mouth and over his head. Simple as that. And now it's on, I could let him come. Sit. Nope, sit. Bunch your butt. Thank you. So once it's on, it has a swivel. So if it turns, it's never going to get caught up onto your leash rope, so it's not going to choke him out unpredictably. And my other leash also has a swivel. The reason why I use a short leash is because when I pull